Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
What is the common thing across all the dependencies that we have provided so far? Country repository is a concrete class. This one is also a concrete class. Here also we are returning a concrete class. App database, we clearly know how to construct that particular object. But this particular thing, that is country list service provider, is not a concrete class. I mean, we have not told Hilt framework how to construct this. So we have to provide country list service provider also. So how do we do that? So let's provide this first. I can write provides, and once again we need a singleton here, and then function provide country list service provider. But if you look at the country list service provider, it is a interface. It is not a real concrete object. Since country list service provider is an interface, Hilt cannot instantiate it directly using add provides unless we provide a concrete implementation. Trying to use provides without returning an actual instance will result in a compilation error. That is the reason why we use binds instead of provides. Let me create a separate module which is an abstract class. So let me close this, close all other tabs, and let me create another file here under the DI. I will call it network module. You can call it anything, but I am pretty sure that I am going to use this particular module to provide dependencies which are related to networking, which is REST API calls like Retrofit and API service. That is the reason why I am calling this particular thing network module. And then I declare this as abstract class. If you want to use binds, then you have to use it within the context of abstract class. That is the reason why we are adding abstract here. Since this is also a module, you have to use module annotation and you have to install this in singleton component. And here I can write binds singleton abstract function bind country list service provider. If you are wondering whether you should use bind with at binds and provide with at provides, this is not mandatory. It is just a convention. That's why when we use provides, the function names typically start with provide, and when we use binds, they start with bind. This function might be returning country list provider via network. Return type is country list service provider. But if you just have a look at this particular country list service provider, it has two implementations. One is country list service provider implementation and country list service provider via network. One provides the data from a local JSON file that is in the raw folder, while the other provides it by making a REST API call. With the way we have implemented our bind function, there is no way for us to differentiate whether we are providing the local JSON based implementation or the REST API based implementation. That is where the concept of at qualifier comes into picture. So, at qualifier is used in Hilt to differentiate multiple bindings of the same type. So what I will do is, I will create another file here. Let me call it service provider qualifier. I will use the at qualifier annotation. This allows us to create custom annotations to differentiate between different implementations. Do you want these at compile time or runtime? That is decided by another annotation called at retention, which defines how long an annotation will be retained. You can use annotation retention dot source, binary, or runtime. Since Hilt processes annotations at compile time, we use annotation retention dot binary, which means the annotation is present at the compiled class files but is not accessible at runtime. And then let me call it as annotation class network provider. And in the same way, let me create another one and call it local provider. And now let me go back to the network module here. And here, since I am returning the country list network provider, under this, I will use network provider here. So now Hilt clearly knows when it is returning country list service provider, by default, it is returning network provider. Since this is returning via network implementation, we need another one, which is local implementation. Since it is not being done through network, let me not define it in the network module. Let me go to the app module here. And then let me write local provider provides singleton function provide country list service provider implementer, and this needs a context country list service provider, and here return country list service provider implementer, pass the context. And since now we have defined the implementation of how to pass the dependency of local implementation of the service provider and the network implementation of the service provider, and we have also implemented the qualifier, we can use that here to determine which one to pass here. So you can write network provider or local provider to decide whenever this repository gets created, what kind of service provider are we going to use? Will it be a local or a network? And if I use the network provider, by default, it is always going to be network. So we are more or less done with it, but there is one more thing that we have to still implement, that is passing the dependencies which are required for the retrofit purpose. And not only that, we will have to think in terms of how to pass these dependencies in the actual code itself. We shall talk about that and more in the next
that
video.
Brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.